Hello everybody, I'm Joel.
And I'm Julian, and welcome to Communication Decoded.
This is your podcast to understand the importance of communication in various situations and also how to improve them. Having strong communication skills aids in all aspects of life, from professional life to personal life and everything that falls in between. From a business standpoint, all transactions result from communication. Good communication skills are essential to allow others and yourself to understand information more accurately and quickly. In contrast, poor communication skills lead to frequent misunderstanding and frustration. In a 2016 LinkedIn survey conducted in the United States, communication topped the list of most sought of soft skills among employers. The first subtopic we'll be talking about is the importance of communication in a relationship. Talk to each other, no matter how well you know and love each other. You cannot read your partner's mind. We need to communicate clearly to avoid misunderstandings that may cause hurt, anger, resentment, or confusion. It takes two people to have a relationship, and each person has different communication needs and styles. Couples need to find a way of communicating that suits their relationship. Healthy communication styles require practice and hard work. Communication will never be perfect all the time. Be clear when you're communicating with your partner, so that your message can be received and understood. Double check your understanding of what your partner is saying. When you are talking to your partner, try to set aside time to talk without interruption from other people or distractions like phones, computers, or television. Think about what you want to say. Be clear about what you want to communicate about. Make your messages clear so that your partner hears it accurately and understands what you mean. Talk about what is happening and how it affects you. Talk about what you want, need, and feel. Use I statements such as I need, I want, and I feel. Accept responsibilities for your own feelings. Listen to your partner. Put aside your own thoughts for the time being and try to understand their intentions, feelings, needs, and wants. This is called empathy. For non-verbal communication, when we communicate, we can say a lot without speaking. Our body posture, tone of voice, and the expressions on our face all convey a message. These non-verbal means of communicating can tell the person how we feel about them. If our feelings don't fit with our words, it is often the non-verbal communication that gets heard and believed. For example, saying I love you to your partner in a flat, bored tone of voice gives two different messages. Notice whether your body language reflects what you are saying.
For listening and communication, listening is very important part of effective communication. A good listener can encourage their partner to talk openly and honestly. Here are a few tips for good listening. Keep comfortable eye contact where culturally appropriate. Lean towards the other person and make gestures to show interest and concern. Have an open, non-defensive, fairly relaxed posture with your arms and legs uncrossed. Respect the other person, don't sit or stand sideways. Sit or stand on the same level to avoid looking up to or down on the other person. Improving and communication in a relationship. Open and clear communication can be learned. Some people find it hard to talk and may need time and encouragement to express their views. These people may be good listeners, or they may be the people whose actions speak louder than their words. You can help to improve your communication by building companionship, sharing experiences, interests, and concerns with your partner, and showing affection and appreciation. Sharing intimacy. Intimacy is not only a sexual connection. Intimacy is created by having moments of feeling close and attached to your partner. It means being able to comfort and be comforted, and to be open and honest. An act of intimacy can be as simple as bringing your partner a cup of tea because you can tell they are tired. Finding one or two key issues you can agree on. such as how finances are distributed, a goal you have, or your parenting styles or strategies. Now, for managing conflict with communication, here are a few tips. Avoid using the silent treatment. Don't jump to conclusions. Find out all the facts rather than guessing at motives. Discuss what actually happened. Don't judge. Learn to understand each other, not to defeat each other. Talk using the future and present tense, not the past tense. Alright, and that's the end of subtopic 1. We'll be taking a quick break and we'll be right back.
Now, moving on to the second subtopic, which is the importance of communication in an organization. Effective communication is the significant for managers in the organizations so as to perform the basic functions of management. Example, planning, organizing, leading, and controlling. Communication helps managers to perform their jobs and responsibilities. Communication serves as a foundation for planning. All the essential information must be communicated to the managers, who in turn must communicate the plans so as to implement them. Organizing also requires effective communication with others about their job tasks. Similarly, leaders as managers must communicate effectively with their subordinates so as to achieve the team goals. Controlling is not possible without written or oral communication. Managers devote a great part of their time in communication. They generally devote approximately 6 hours per day in communicating. They spend great time on face-to-face or telephonic communication with their superiors, subordinates, colleagues, customers, or suppliers. Managers also use written communication in forms of letters, reports, or memos wherever oral communication is not feasible. Thus, we can say that effective communication is a building block of successful organizations. In other words, communication acts as organizational blood.
Now, the importance of communication in an organization can be summarized as follows. 1. Communication promotes motivation by informing and clarifying the employees about the task to be done, the manner they are performing the task, and how to improve their performance if it is not up to the mark. Secondly, communication is a source of information to the organizational members for decision-making process, as it helps identifying and assessing alternative course of actions. Third, communication also plays a crucial role in altering individuals' attitudes. Example, a well-informed individual will have a better attitude than a less informed individual. Organizational magazines, journals, meetings, and various other forms of oral and written communication helps in molding employees' attitudes. Communication also helps in socializing. In today's life, the only presence of another individual fosters communication. It is also said that one cannot survive without communication. Fifth, as discussed earlier, communication also assists in controlling process. It helps controlling organizational members' behavior in various ways. There are various levels of hierarchy and certain principles and guidelines that employees must follow in an organization. They must comply with organizational rules, policies, perform their job role efficiently, and communicate any work problem and grievance to their superiors. Thus, communication helps in controlling function of management. An effective and efficient communication system requires managerial proficiency in delivering and receiving messages. A manager must discover various barriers to communication, analyze the reasons for their occurrence, and take preventive steps to avoid those barriers. Thus, the primary responsibility of a manager is to develop and maintain an effective communication system in the organization. Alright, now that will be the end of subtopic 2, but don't leave yet, we'll be right back.
Now, for the third subtopic, it will be on how to improve your communication skills. It will be ending soon, so bear with us. Here are some pointers to look out for when looking to improve your ability to effectively communicate with others. Firstly, listening. To become a good communicator, it is important to be a good listener. It is important to practice active listening. Pay close attention to what others are saying and clarify ambiguities by rephrasing their questions for greater understanding. Second, conciseness. Convey your message in as few words as possible. Do not use filler words and get straight into the point. Rambling will cause the listener to tune out or be unsure of what you are talking about. Avoid speaking excessively and do not use words that may confuse the audience. Thirdly, body language. It is important to practice good body language. Use eye contact. Utilize hand gestures and watch the tone of the voice when communicating with others. A relaxed body stance with a friendly tone will aid in making you look approachable by others. Eye contact is important in communication. So, do look at the person in the eye to indicate that you are focused on the conversation. But make sure to not stare at the person as it can make him or her uncomfortable.
Now for the fourth one, it will be confidence. Be confident in what you say and in your communication interactions with others. Being confident can be as easy as maintaining eye contact, maintaining a relaxed body stance, and talking with concision. Try not to make statements sound like questions, and avoid trying to sound aggressive or demanding. Open-mindedness. In situations where you disagree with what someone else has to say, whether it be with an employer, a co-worker, or a friend, it is important to sympathize with their point of view, rather than simply try to get your message across. Respect the opinion of others and never resort to demanding those who do not agree with you. For the sixth one, respect. Respecting what others have to say and acknowledging them is an important aspect of communication. Being respectful can be as simple as paying attention to what they have to say, using the person's name and not being distracted. By respecting others, the other person will feel appreciated, which will lead to a more honest and productive conversation. And for the seventh one, using the correct medium. There are several different forms of communication to use. It is important to choose the right one. For example, communicating in person about serious matters, layoff, salary changes, etc. is more appropriate than sending an email regarding the matter.
Alright, and that's the end. Thanks for listening to Communication Decoded. We hope you enjoy the show. Don't forget to rate and review the show wherever you access this podcast. Thank you and have a nice day.